CNN loses 70% of its viewers since Biden became president. So CNN is having multiple meltdowns every night, constantly spreading hateful lies intended to destroy the American nation and stir up violence and terror against American citizens. But that's not the only meltdown the CCP-inspired network is facing. It's also losing American viewers at record levels as the network is seeing drops in ratings of 70% since January of this year. And this is from Newsbusters. CNN ratings go down the toilet, tumbling over 70% since January. And there's an excerpt. Along with its ongoing ethical problems, a deceptive marketing campaign, and a continued hatred for non-liberal voices, just to continue, they're not liberals. Stop this. See, this is again, what Newsbusters is doing is claiming that tired mantle, that this is conservative versus liberal. That's not what we're talking about. This is far beyond conservatives, and more Americans, I'm hoping and praying and believing, more Americans who wouldn't count themselves as conservatives are going to recognize that they should be standing with the conservatives right now. They should be standing with the libertarians, not the Libertarian Party libertarians, because the Libertarian Party libertarians are kind of like soft progressives, and I don't mean soft like deep blue-collar labor-type progressivism. I mean more like CCP kind of progressivism. So I wouldn't trust the Libertarian Party, per se. But in general, this isn't a battle between conservatism and liberalism. This is a battle between the Bill of Rights and anyone who wants to destroy the Bill of Rights in the name of saving people from some impending boogeyman doom. Whether it's we have to throw away the Bill of Rights so we can protect people from white supremacism. So we have to discriminate against human beings because of the color of their skin and their sexual orientation, because that's the only way that we'll stop the discrimination that has happened to certain other groups and certain other race and sexual orientation classes. Those people aren't Americans. They're Chinese Communist Party acolytes, whether they know it or not. And we need more and more Americans to come to realize this isn't a battle between conservatives and progressives. This is a battle between Americans and basically the new right. The new right is the DNC. So I'll continue here. I'll back up real quickly here. Along with its ongoing ethical problems, a deceptive marketing campaign, and a continued hatred for non-liberal voices, just basically... A continued hatred for American voices. It's been a terrible, horrible, no good, very bad year for Jeffrey Zucker's led CNN. And as per the latest Nielsen rating, CNN has continued to hemorrhage viewers with primetime and entry. Let's see, with primetime and entire day total viewership down over 70% since January. Nielsen Media Research has the breakdown, and it's not pretty, no matter how the Zuckerberg, I like that Zuckerberg, that's pretty good, since a January high of roughly 798,000 primetime viewers and 530,000 total day viewers in the 25 to 54 Democratic graphic, CNN has fallen off a cliff and into the pit of misery, with the network fetching only 229,000 in primetime and 152,000 in total day over the past month. You realize there are many YouTube channels that will regularly get over 152,000 views? Just bloggers sitting in their mom's basement doing commentary. We're not one of them, unfortunately. We have like, I don't know, 20 subscribers, whatever we have. So we're not one of them. But there are those out there that are getting more views per day than CNN is getting on its network. Now, to be fair, CNN might very well get more views on YouTube than it does on its own ratings channel. And that is a factor as far as why some networks might be losing viewers to some degree. But it doesn't really nearly explain nearly as much of it. And certainly Fox News hasn't suffered nearly as much of a decline. Not that I'm a Fox News fan, because Fox News is kind of like they're basically the conservatives, and the conservatives are largely, whether you want to be or not, you are largely the Washington Generals. You are a team that's built to lose. So long as you continue to couch this whole issue, this whole conflict that we're seeing rising in America, as between conservatives and progressives, you'll continue to be that. You have to take this outside of the scope of conservatism and make this plainly about the Bill of Rights. That is the clear marker that we can stand on, the clear marker that we can point to and say, you're violating the Bill of Rights standards. You're crossing the line. We don't care why you're doing it. We don't care how you tell us that it's going to save the children. None of us are buying it. You don't save poor children by taking away an ideational construct, which Bill of Rights is an ideational construct that lives in our hearts, the hearts of many Americans. You don't protect the poor by taking away such a powerful ideational construct that puts a real power impediment on those that have, who would otherwise continue to consolidate their power and use their power advantage to control even more those that have not, to assure that there are no new challengers to their thrones. That's what this is all about. It's all about eliminating competition, plain and simple. It's not ideology. It's nothing. They don't care about homosexuals. They don't care about black people. They don't care about anything other than controlling the narrative so that they control the lives of the poor so they don't have to compete. And I tell you the truth, you people on the left, the quote-unquote left, who continue to support the DNC, you're violating your own leftist standards because you're not standing with the poor anymore. You're not standing with the disenfranchised anymore. You're standing with the billionaires. And it's no coincidence that all the billionaires, they don't walk lockstep behind you. You walk lockstep behind them. They're the ones that push the particular version of this critical race theory garbage onto the land that continues to spread the lie that white people and heterosexuals and males invented evil, and the only way that we can end evil is to end these constructs called whiteness, maleness, and heterosexual normativity. That's their underlying assumption. And if you continue to support such vile, evil lies, don't call yourself leftist anymore. You're right-wing nut jobs is what you are. You're right-wing nut jobs. Get off the right-wing nut job farm. Don't join the conservatives. Join the Bill of Rights team. Team Bill of Rights. We should start a party, and we should call it the King Bill Party. And that's real simple. The King Bill Party. We're not going to sell issues of levels of taxation, whether we should tax the rich or whatever, we got all of those differences. The bottom line is, whatever you want to do, you must do it within the constraints of the Bill of Rights. Otherwise, get the fuck out. And that's how I'm going to end this little video.